Good morning, AK. This is Cadet Second Lieutenant Lizette Pinto with your Marine Corps JROTC. Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, and with liberty and justice for all. Enjoy the rest of your day, AK.
I'm Maggie Williams.
I'm Stella Lucy.
And I'm Simone Cullum, and these are your morning announcements.
There will be an Audrey Kell Wrestling Interest Meeting on October 5th at 7 p.m. Please enroll in the AK Wrestling Remind by texting AKW20 to 81010 to access the Zoom link. If you have any questions prior to the meeting, please email Coach Holmes at BREOND.Holmes@cms.k12.nc.us.
The 2020 election is less than 6 weeks away. Early voting starts October 15th, and if you are already a registered voter and want to confirm your registration, go to vote411.org. Unfortunately, signing up through the DMV does not guarantee registration with the NC Board of Elections. If you did not receive a voter registration card in the mail, you are not registered. Use the link to double check. Also, if you're a first-time voter, get a first-time voter checklist and go out to find your polling place location in which offices and districts you will be able to vote for. If you're not registered, it only takes about 2 minutes to vote. Go to vote411.org. In order to vote, you must be registered by October 9th and you must be, first, a U.S. citizen, at least 18 by November 3rd, and a resident in the county in which you live. If you cannot vote in this election but are still interested in the voting process, look at becoming a poll worker. This is a paid volunteer position and you can earn service hours. You must be 17 by November 3rd. Contact Ms. Tonneson at leahc.tonneson@cms.k12.nc.us to find out more information.
Hey, Audrey Kell, are you interested in learning more about Jewish culture and traditions? If so, you should join the AK Jewish Culture Club. The AK Jewish Culture Club is open to all students and the interest meeting is on Wednesday, October 7th at 4 p.m. Follow at AKHSJCC on Instagram for more details.
Do you want to be a member of AK DECA? Remember to have all information submitted by Tuesday, October 6th. This includes completing the Google form and paying your dues. Please check social media sites or the AK DECA Weebly for more information.
The Knights Around the World interest meeting is on October 5th at 2:50 p.m. Join if you are interested in helping refugees and volunteering from home. Follow their Instagram at AKKATW and join their Remind by texting Knights, A-R-O, to 81010. You must join the Remind in order to get the Zoom link. Additionally, the AK Gay Straight Alliance will host an interest meeting via Teams on Thursday, October 8th for anyone interested in joining the organization. It will be held via Microsoft Teams. To join the team, please go to bit.ly/AK-GSA.
Did you miss the latest episode of Friday Nights, the AK Theater's very own SNL style show? Well, not to worry, you can always see previous episodes on the Audrey Kell Theater YouTube channel. Subscribe and hit the bell to get notifications of when new episodes premiere. Our next episode is scheduled for October 23rd. If you are interested in being featured on a future show, email Mr. Gabbard or Ms. Ralph.
Economics Club is meeting today at 3 o'clock. Join us on Zoom. Attention juniors and sophomores interested in learning more about Governor's School. There will be a Zoom information meeting on October 7th and October 15th at 6 p.m. Please visit the AK website main page or the counselor's page to find the Zoom link. Email Ms. DiPierno if you have any questions.
If you are interested in learning more about the current clubs at AK, be sure to check out the Inner Club Council's updated website at akicc.weebly.com. Short club videos and information for all of our clubs can be found on the club's website, find under the club info tab.
Our staff birthdays for this week are Miss Griffith, Miss Franchi, Coach Bagwell, and Miss Wendt. Happy birthday. And if you missed any announcements, go to the WAKK Announcements tab on the AK website and everything said today will be there.
Today we're going to watch a video on famous Latinos, but have a great day, AK.
Hi, my name is Alondra Olmos. I'm from Venezuela, and we're going to talk about famous Hispanics. Hispanics have been influential figures in American society for many years. Here are just a few influential Latino leaders in politics, music, law, science, sports, and more.
Hi, my name is Larissa, and I'm from Costa Rica and Mexico. Cesar Chavez is a Mexican-American who fought for civil rights activists. As a young boy, he dropped out of school to help support his family through field work. After a stint in the U.S. Navy, Chavez returned to the field with determination to better the lives of workers like him. And Chavez was a champion of nonviolent protesting. Sonia Sotomayor, Puerto Rican descent, she was confirmed as the first Latina Supreme Court Justice in U.S. history. She is a graduate of Yale and Princeton University, instructor at NYU and Columbia Law Schools, best-selling children's book author. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez has Puerto Rican descent. At 29 years old, she is the youngest woman ever elected to the U.S. Congress. She is a Boston University graduate, and she has worked as a waitress and bartender to support her family after her father's death, deepening her commitment to issues impacting working class people. Lin-Manuel Miranda has Puerto Rican descent, is a composer, writer, and actor, is the creator of the hip-hop musical Hamilton, winner of MacArthur Foundation Genius Grant, nominated for a Pulitzer Prize, and won a Grammy. Ellen Ochoa has Mexican descent, was the first Hispanic woman in space, engineer and co-inventor of 3 patents, and is director of Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas.
Hi guys, I am Miss Whitney, or Senora Whitney. I am half Puerto Rican and half Dominican. We're gonna continue on with the famous Hispanics, the next 5. We have Manu Ginobili, who is Argentinian. He played for the San Antonio Spurs from 2002 to 2018. Has 4 NBA championships and also got an Olympic gold medal playing for Argentina. And next we have Rita Moreno. Rita Moreno is a Puerto Rican. She is the first Hispanic actress to ever receive an Oscar. And she's done something that few people have done before, which is win all 4 major North America Entertainment Awards. So she has an Emmy, a Grammy, an Oscar, and a Tony. You might have recognized her if you've seen The West Side Story, the original, that you might recognize her from there. Also from Netflix, she has a show there as well. Silvia Mendez is Mexican descent. She is the first Mexican-American to go to an all-white school in California. Her parents sued and won the case Mendez versus Westminster in 1947, desegregating all public schools in California. This case actually paved the way for the Brown versus Board of Education. Next, we have Joe Quesada. He is of Cuban descent. He is a comic book writer and artist and chief executive officer of Marvel. So he is responsible for a lot of our movies like Spider-Man, all these movies that come from the Marvel field. So he produced movies like Iron Man and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. And next we have Jorge Ramos, who is Mexican. He is an anchor of the Spanish language Univision Lightning News. So if you ever watch the Spanish TV, you might see him. He's one of Time's most influential people. And he once got slugged by Fidel Castro's bodyguard for asking Castro if Cuba should ever hold democratic elections. So there's a few artists that you might not know had Latino heritage. So Demi Lovato is actually part Mexican. Bruno Mars has a Puerto Rican father. Cardi B is half Dominican. And Alexis Bleda, if you know her from Gilmore Girls, she is Argentinian and Mexican. Hope you enjoy learning about these Latino influential figures.
Hi, Hi, my name is Lee Hepworth, and I'm going to explain the Jewish holiday of Sukkot. Sukkot is an agricultural festival that originally was considered a Thanksgiving for the fruit harvest. Sukkot commemorates the years that the Jews spent in the desert on their way to the Promised Land and celebrates the way in which God protected them under difficult desert conditions. Sukkot is celebrated by building a sukkah. A sukkah is a hut-like temporary home that the Jews stayed in during the time they spent in the wilderness after leaving Egypt. The sukkah is decorated with fruits and symbols of the harvest. During the 8 days of Sukkot, people eat and some people even sleep in their sukkah. One of the traditions done in the sukkah is shaking the lulav and the etrog. The lulav is a palm branch which is joined with myrtle and willow branches, and an etrog is a citron fruit similar to a lemon. Here is a description of the Jewish holiday Sukkot by Miss Brand's 5-year-old nephew in Ohio.
Hello, my name is Ori, and I'm going to be teaching you about the Jewish holiday Sukkot.
Okay, Ori, what is Sukkot?
It's a holiday where we remember the Jews when they lived in houses which are temporary, and you can call them huts or temporary houses, and their journey.
Their journey from where to where?
Egypt to Israel.
So Sukkot is the holiday where we remember when the Jews left Egypt on their way to Israel and lived in temporary housing.
Right.
And a sukkah is what?
Well, a temporary house, or you could call them a hut.
And where do we build them?
Outside.
Outside. And do we get to decorate them?
Yes.
Awesome. So what do we do in our sukkah?
We shake the lulav, have our meals, and sometimes, just sometimes, sleep in there.
And sometimes sleep in there. And is Sukkot, how long is it? Is it 1 day or more than 1 day?
More than 1 day.
How many days?
8.
Wow. What's your favorite part about Sukkot?
Ooh. My favorite part of it is eating the pumpkins.
We eat pumpkins in our sukkah? Sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes.
Is Sukkot also part of the harvest festival?
Yes!
Yeah, so we eat a lot of fall fruits and vegetables in our sukkah. Right. To remind us of all the yummy foods that we get to have in the fall. All right, you did a great job. You want to say goodbye to everybody?
Not right now.
Oh, okay. Is there anything else you want to say about Sukkot?
Yes.
Oh, okay. What?
The etrog represents ourselves, and an etrog is a lemony sort of fruit from Israel, and bye-bye, everyone. I hope you had a good time learning about the Jewish holiday Sukkot. Bye-bye!
I hope you learned something today about the Jewish holiday of Sukkot.